Welcome to our newest listing in the heart of Middleburg. A short walk to the downtown. It's quaint, it's convenient. More importantly, this property's been reclaimed. Built in the late 1700s, there was a lot of work to be done. You'll see as you go through this magnificent property, everything that's been reclaimed, including the stone and the infrastructure, so you truly believe like you're living in a piece of not only art, but also history. Come join us for a tour as we walk you through your new home.
Welcome to 23381 Samfred Road in Middleburg, Virginia, the home I like to affectionately call the East Gate to Middleburg. It's right outside of town. You can walk in town from here. It's very close to Salamander Market and all the wonderful things that Middleburg started to offer, has always offered, but now it's really coming on as like a little bit of a leisure and a destination tourist spot. And I found this place, I've actually been aware of this place since I moved here 25 years ago, because it's so prominently featured right on Route 50. And it's the Baltimore House, because the Baltimores used to live here, and Mr. Baltimore used to sit outside the house and wave and greet everybody when they would come in. So I've always kind of had a nice little affection for it. Plus, it had a beautiful little Victorian type of feel that I'd always kind of liked. It just felt good. You could tell it was needed some work and things like that, but it was always beautiful, had flowers around it. So I had the opportunity to pick up this place a couple years ago, and I've been working on it ever since. That the hardwood floors are obviously, you know, quite amazing, especially in this room. This is, I call this the tavern room. It's kind of like, you know, an old English or Scottish kind of tavern, that kind of vibe with the stone and the old floors. And then I would bring in elements, like the old beams for structural purposes, and as well to be able to open up the rooms to give it more light and let the light shine through. I've done a lot of that prominently with a lot of the old windows that I've used in the house to bring that light in. It's a very nice setting here, the way it's set, for the sun patterns and even the moon patterns. You can see those at night. The newer items I like to bring in to blend the old with the new is the elements like the staircases. Got a spiral staircase that leads up to the master bedroom area that I affectionately call the crow's nest. And then this staircase behind me, I think can you see that over there? And those type of modern elements that I like. I love the modern, I love the feel of things. It's kind of like that part of me that I was talking about with California, but I'm also kind of a Virginia boy too. So I like my old, I like my antiques, I like my stuff, but I like my flashy loft spaces as well. So I try to combine those type of things into a space that I think I can enjoy and that others will too. When people would walk into this kitchen, it would feel very new, it would feel modern, it would feel usable in that way, but it would also feel like it's been there. It could have been there for, you know, 100 years or so. There is an old sink I've incorporated, an old farm sink that I got. Same type of situation. It's just gorgeous old porcelain farm sink. Weighs as much as a car, I think. And then you bring that in and you centerpiece that into your kitchen, and then you customize things around it as you need to. You do a little bit of woodwork or tile work or whatever to kind of update it and bring it. But that enables a certain energy to be kind of trapped in there versus maybe something if you go to a Lowe's or Home Depot or an upscale design store. Nothing against those places, but you know, you'll notice the energy when you come in. You'll feel that kind of recycled vibe where it's updated, but it's still pieces that have lived a life and still have a lot to give. The Crow's Nest is a really fun space in this house. I really enjoyed working on it, but it was quite a challenge. This house has presented a lot of challenges because it's quite small. It's about 2,000 square feet, which isn't huge, but it's on three levels. And to open it up so the house really feels open and flowing like an old New York brownstone or something like that was a challenge. And the last capping of it, to try to use every little bit of space that you had going up into the Crow's Nest, the way that they had the stairs, I went ahead and modified the entrance to the upstairs using a spiral staircase to reach it, and then getting up there so that could become like a little private sanctuary. You know, you've got a little spot up there on the top, and you've got, you know, your dual vanities and your tub and your stand-up shower and your walk-in closet. And then there's also some really interesting elements up there to try to shoehorn everything in, as well as leaving some of the original parts of the house. There's the old cedar-shaped roof that goes back. The original roof to this house was actually buried up there in the attic, so I went ahead and left that exposed as part of the Crow's Nest, so people can always have a link to the history of this house.